start with, I've got, yeah, let's drop this one. So I just pasted this thing here. So I need to make sure this background is empty. So 99% time in games we use TARGA, TGA format. But there are cases where we use PNG, because PNG can have an alpha without an alpha channel. So if I delete this, now there is no background. If I select this magic wand, similar, all white is selected, delete this, now the background is empty. And if I save this as PNG, it will retain this emptiness. If you save this as TGA, it will make this background as white. So there are cases we do this, but 99% time we use TARGA. Reason, there is a reason why. If I save this at PNG, and this background will automatically, it will read as white. Like it will read as white, but it will give you a transparency. So I'll show you both the things. I created this. If I save as PNG, my folder only, right? So I saved it. So now I have to create a plane for it. This thing, remove everything, max to max, 1 center line, so that I can identify where is my center. 1 center line, and drag, drop this link here. So you can see it was a PNG, but background become white automatically. If I apply this, this one, this image, copy to opacity. Copy and alpha. You can see it become transparent. This is PNG. So PNG by default gives you this alpha, but problem with the edges become slightly whitish. Slightly whitish. But in case of TARGA, now I want to save it as TARGA. If I save it like just like this, it will again give you a white background. So for TARGA, what we do is first click select this, go to channels and click a new channel. Right? If you have the selection, it will create the alpha automatically. Or if you select or fill white. So alpha channel. Now I have a background here. I'll fill green. So no matter what I do, my background will always be green. It won't give me that white edge. That is something wrong. Like a lot of people do that. And plus we do this, and sometime we do one more thing here. Because this green is varying from one part to another part, right? It's not same everywhere. So sometime it might give me an issue. So I'll just corners. This is a fill slightly green. So no matter what happens, edges will be green always. Sharpness of diffuse, but not alpha. Alpha is intact. So because it will be visible based on the alpha. Not no control edge. Like either you can paint this thing, like suppose I have this texture, but I don't have a selection. So either I have to manually select this with pen tool and create a selection, fill white, to fill white there. So now whatever I do, this will be always green. Build it. Now we have these three layers, and if I save this, as Tarka, _01. So I can identify and 32 bit because there's alpha. And there you can see all these white edges. And 01 Tarka, drag drop. You can see there is no white edges. Fix this. Opacity, copy, opacity, alpha channel. Now you can see there is no white, all green. And because alpha was crisp, so no matter what you do, it will be crisp only. Because alpha is means mask, that opacity. Opacity mask is crisp. So in your texture, it's blur or what, no, doesn't matter. So now you have this one. So I created this leaf. Now I want to generate this shrub or small plant. So right now I can see this thing supposed to align with this so that I can align it very nicely. Right? So there's two ways of doing it. I can convert to editable poly, select all the edges, and there is something called preserve UV and move it. So it will preserve the UV and move it here. And then move this also center. And this thing also move to center. So instead of keeping it like extra, I can push it here. Clear? This is the clear, I guess, right? There's no issue. Now, this leaves, usually they are not this flat. They need to have some amount of dimension or volume. So, slightly bend. Now, in between, this branch, usually branch, they are like slightly curved, usually, most of the time. So, not necessarily, but yes. So, what I'll do, select all the edges. Yes. Connect it and you can move it up and move it down. So from a distance it will look like a volume. Like you can see, it doesn't look flat. So I have some little angle. I can make it really detailed. If I want, I can create geometry around this with cut tool around this properly and make each and every leaf separate, or maybe add more volume to it. I can definitely do that, or I can, like, suppose I have this cut. So for each leaf, let's see, let's add, make it a little detailed so it becomes a little easy for you to understand. Connect. So now, yes, I'm increasing the polygon just to make it a little detailed. So I can move this thing and this part, I can move it here. So you can see I'm not working on UV, I'm working on directed texture, because planes are usually unwrapped. If it's not unwrapped, unwrap it and then work on your model. So that's why you follow, create this thing first. Okay, my bad. Oh, angle change. So there is no polygons, that's why it's bending. So I need to add this thing, connect it here. In this case, because it was bending unusually, so I have to connect this, or I have to flip this triangle. It's my flip. Flip is here, no, somewhere. Turn. No. There's an option called flip. Okay, I'll just manually do it. So, cut. So I can delete this also, backspace. Or maybe I can keep it like this, and this edge is not, this vertex is not required, so I have to make sure I delete this. I snap it here somewhere, let's snap it here and then weld it, it will go. So let's do target weld. So this time if I do target weld, it is updating my UV as well, even if it's on. So it's better to fix this thing, or let me change it. Like this also works perfectly. So now let me move this thing. Put it down. If I want to create a detail, so I have to add more polygons, more loops, and make it nicely detailed. I can add more detail, one more loop here and create some variation, or maybe I can add one more loop here and add some variation. That is totally up to me, like how detailed this plant is. So now a basic leaf is ready, and if you see from distance, I can see the volume, right? Like it's not flat surface anymore. Now, so I need a branch first here. So for that, again a cylinder. Grid. All these loops are not required. Polygon. Usually tip is slightly narrow. So I can keep it narrow. Any kind of branch or anything you want to create, you can create that. Now. So now you can see this wherever this stem is, this should connect to this thing, right? So based on that, I have to fit it. And or I can do pivot point. Vertex is on already. It's much easier to control. Top view. Oh, snap is on. Slightly from inside, so it's become part of this thing. Now I want to shift and rotate. Copy. Slightly down. I can modify the geometry again if I want. all three, there are three different direction. I can select all three. There are like two types of plants. They have like parallelly multiple branches, or they have alternative branches always. That's how nature works. So usually, the most of time, if this is here, this will go somewhere here, slightly, and this one will go somewhere here. This is how nature works. So select all three of them. If you want, you can combine them. So personally, I prefer to combine them. Attach. Gradually reduce the size. That's how plants work. So applying alpha, reason is so that I can see this stem where it's connected. If you don't apply alpha, if I just place a plane, I don't know where I'm placing. Right. So then again connecting this. Then again I have to once you apply all the alpha planes. You have to go to UV or manually fix all the edges. So now I can see everything, I can do it at once. So I save a lot of time here. And I can rotate this. Yes.
After fixing
everything,
then
we'll create it. Occlusion. So that's why you can keep a basic plane, or once you create the texture, bake the ambient occlusion once again. So here I can see there's a difference. So okay, this one, except this one, everything is touching the surface. So now, phaser UV should switch off. Every time you have to duplicate, rotate, change the angle. So, because nature is like dynamic, there is like they don't repeat usually. You have to make sure everything looks nice and dynamic. This is like one texture but multiple variation, everything different angles, and you can add more branches, make it dense, and this is just one leaf. You can have an entire bush, and you can just duplicate multiple types, or maybe an entire branch, so it will give you more detailed result. And make sure whatever your texture is, apply the same color in the background. Otherwise, no matter what you do, that white dotted line will be there, and this is that is something not acceptable, wrong. So make sure add this thin color, and then apply, and good to go. And this alpha can be anything. Alpha can be anything. It's not just restricted to your leaves. It is like eyelashes, alpha. Your hair, alpha. Your like suppose you have cloth, torn cloth. That is also alpha. You have a chain link or something like a chain. That's also alpha. Like suppose you put that everything is alpha, yes. So suppose I have let's create a very basic this thing, and I want to create a texture here. Shape, and corners. I want corners rounded. Maybe 10 pixels. Maybe 40. shift everything, control C, control D, and control T, resize it, and keep it selected and change it to subtract. So it is subtracted. So now I created this thing. Let's see if it can be, let's keep it green color. And control, now I have to create one more shape. Control, okay, new layer, control V. So it will act as a mask, control J. Delete that. Chain link. So if I want to create this, I can have only one of this. Suppose I want to create this thing, so what I'll do is select this and alpha I have to apply, and this color I don't even like it, so I'll just keep it with some gray, and same gray I fill in the background. Some color issue. So anyways, this thing is ready and I want to create some texture. So let's add some bevel emboss so that I can see it. Just randomly I'm adding this thing. So my alpha is there already. I save this at Targa. Now, again, I have a frame. So, turn my auto credit on. Apply. Alpha. You can see it clearly. You can, like, if you want to make it wide, narrow, or cut those sides, extra things, and it's ready. And material, this one. You can see there's something called two-sided. Click on this, so now this will be visible from both the sides. Now, I want to create chain link. I am doing it like this. Like, there will be cases where this kind of chain or something is the part of your scene or something, but it's not very evident, or it's like quite far away from the camera. That case we'll use alpha for not just for one chain. We'll create the entire chain itself in alpha, just to give you an idea. Like, this is how we can add things. What happened here? Just to give you an idea, I can create the entire chain link like this, one by one, if recently close, or maybe something is there. We can add over like one plane and add all this detail. This alpha can be anything. So usually, like, if you have especially characters, you have those cloth, you have those hair, eyelashes, all these things are alpha. So foliage is again alpha. So that is something to understand. Alpha can be used everywhere. It can be a piece of metal. It's a piece of metal, right? It can be anything. The whatever map you are connecting, based on that will give you output. So that is something you have to keep in mind. Alpha can be everything. So and how to use it? So if you have this thing, So this, suppose this is my texture, this is this file. So alpha and other stuff in max viewport doesn't go together. You can apply one material to everything and apply one texture, but it will look transparent. Like if you see here, you can kind of see through this thing. Right, that's a problem with the alpha material. That has nothing to do with your texture, nothing to do with your model. It's problem with the alpha material, how it calculates. It will render properly, but give you a viewport to give you an issue. So what we do for this, so like suppose this branch and this pot and this leaf is part of one texture, suppose. In that case, what I'll do is I'll separate the material for this with alpha and same texture applied, but there is no alpha applied to it. So it will give you proper output. It's just to make this thing clean. This thing, I need to chamfer it. Lot of these, I can fix it. Well, those two are like way too far. Let us clean all this thing slowly to add all the details. All this thing nicely. This is clear, right? There's no confusion. So this is how you can add any foliage. It can be anything, depending upon like what you want to create. It can be one leaf. It can be a bunch of leaves. If I open bridge. Grass and all these things. These are all 3D assets. If I download any one of them, your foliage depends. Like depending on the resolution. Like this is for this bridge is for basically production. Like not for movie. Like production as in product game production or movie production, anything. So they give you very high quality assets, and based on that, whatever you need, you can reduce it or increase it. So let's go to file and let's see if we working. Stem is basically two planes, and leaves are basically this kind of random shapes with all those bunch of textures. I'll show you the textures. You can see texture, all the edges are blurred out, see, mixed. just how you use it. It's all about that. It is a nice looking plant. It's just a plate. And crisscross plate. Not just like one plate, you see. So that from all directions you can see a volume. It's not just one plane. Two planes everywhere. So that you can see it from all the directions. Any direction you look at, you always see the leaf, the branch, stem, you can see everything because there are two planes, crisscross. That's why you can see it all the time. Similarly, let's see. Grass or maybe something like this. This can be related to me. Something like this. You see pot and flower. Let's download this. These are scanned. Quixel bridge is all scanned. These are all photo scans. So we can do it like the way we are creating this thing. So the same way they create. They use photo, crop it and paste it, copy paste, copy paste. That's how they do it. So let's see. Version 1. This I'm using version 1. The LOD 0 means highest level of detail. LOD 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 means lowest level. Number increases means lowest quality. So I'll show that thing also. Continue. Let's see. Step 4. You see, this is LOD 0, highest detail. So they create one leaf, rotate, place, and add some variation here and there to generate this thing. Plus, same thing, located everywhere, and alpha. Now this everything is clean, and you can see this see-through thing. This is what happens with transparency material. This is not your fault or anything. It's shader problem. You can see everything is nice and clean. Now for same flower, same thing, I'll show you LOD 14. So under LOD 14 also, oh this is a variation. I have LOD 5. Yeah. LOD 5 is just two planes. And you cannot apply this texture here. If I try to apply this thing, it looks like this. So for this we use billboards. Billboards are basically flat textures. Grass, that is billboard. So see, applied it. It's just the image from front view. And two planes with exact same texture, material. So from distance, it looks kind of similar only. So this is what we do for close-up shot, this is for distance shot. So this is how you optimize. So alpha can be really detailed, can be really low quality. This is called billboards, basically flat textures. Nothing is there, it's just a flat one-sided texture. You just paste it there. That's called billboard. Billboards, you have the flat billboards. Same thing, billboards. Normal texturing proper, like this is you create properly with all alpha based on the UV channels, and this is you create the texture and it plays the UV based on the texture. You can see same thing to a different variation.
So
you have a close-up shot, then go for something like this. If you have distance shot, go for this. And in game, most of the time we use this. If you have played any game, you'll see most of the grass foliage are like billboards. They are not detailed. Unless you have a cinematic shot or maybe a camera angle where the foliage is very close, then only this. Otherwise, everything is billboard. Interactive foliage. In that time, if that also interactive foliage, maybe suppose you have a creeper. That creeper is again a billboard. But if you have this falling leaves, that is single textures. Single plane with texture. That again works differently. This is how you can create anything. It can be like any kind of thing alpha you can generate. You can see there is no limit. You can generate any kind of plant, any kind of things very easily. Even cactus, okay, this can be a good example. They have seen, so this can be a billboard, can be a 3D model as well. Because usually cactus have thickness. Most of the plants, they from a distance, they are kind of one-sided. Complete geometry, and let's have a LOD file. This is again complete geometry, but you can see poly count difference. So this is how, because this region, this have thickness, and it's a from distance also from everywhere you can see the thickness, because it's like round shape. So it will cast shadow and highlight. So no matter what you do, if it's like really 1 kilometer away, then you can have a billboard. But it's like still you can see it clearly. You need to have some amount of volume there. That's how you can create all this thing. Yes. This looks quite nice. If I want to make it a little detailed. Yes, like this. No. So from distance, now it becomes a little denser. Based on the front distance from the camera, that's what we do. Gaming is all about faking it, like how you can fake it. Because you cannot have millions of polygons. So less polygons, if you have to understand how to combine texture and model together and how to get maximum output out of that. It's all about that. So because your texture and model both are equally important. If your model is not good enough, and no matter what you do in texture, you cannot do anything. If your model is very good, but your texture is very bad, and it will look bad. So balance both the things, balance of both the things. From distance, see so many flowers. These are these flowers. This is what we can do. That we create all these things very easily. Creepers. All if you see this, okay, this creeper I can show you. This is really nice. That's wind effect. So wind effect in Unreal. That's an engine thing. That's nothing to do with your actual model. That's basically animated material. In that material, it animates. Think of all those things. That's nothing to do with us. But those things I'll teach, how to do it. It's pretty simple. It's very easy. Blueprints is a visual scripting. So you can see it's just some random plane. In game engine everything is emulated. So in this, I'll open one more. Amazing. just a plane. Just a plane. Now I go to texture. You can see this won't work on this. This supposed to work on this. Because billboard is a flat plane, so you cannot have this kind of texture. You need to have something very specific. From distance, it looks pretty nice. Is it visible? Okay. So, the background change in billboard texture. Exact same thing, just a texture applied. Is with alpha, nothing else. So, from distance, both will look exactly same. This can have animation, this cannot have animation. This have kindness and we have more polygons here, so we can move this polygon. Here we cannot do it. And it's a very good quality asset work there. It is this one. See, alpha, it's all about your planning. How you planning it and what kind of quality you want to create based on that alpha. So it can be foliage, can be anything, or can be a creeper, can be some piece of jewelry, anything. So it's like it's just how you plan it, how many planes you have, how many geometry, how much geometry you have, or maybe full detailed geometry. So anything is possible. You can create whatever you want. I applied alpha and then created it already. So what I did is I created one leaf and one plane and duplicate. That's it. I checked that and then I placed it. Because you have to check that alpha, because if you don't check it, suppose I randomly place this kind of plane, I don't know from where it's starting or where it's ending. So it becomes very difficult. So that's what you need to apply alpha to place it. You can have a generic alpha also, any generic, just a shape of leaf to understand. Then you can make it nice, clean, and very good quality, high quality texture. So usually you need to have a basic alpha, always for alpha. Create something like this. Again, time gone.